Oh.
Oh, have you tried?
Come on, baby.
Come on, come on.
I told you there were better.
Somebody likes him anyway.
I
know. Now these knights are not deaf. When they come around the curve and start going for the finish line, you can yell and scream and encourage them. They don't mind.
5 pounds of green, blue and gold.
Come on!
My lords and my ladies, in recognition of the fact that this man has, for the second time this day, performed very neatly and has kept his record spotless, although he dropped his hat in the mud, we give for him this token, which is good for a hat.
There she is with
the This will determine the victory.
I am really hard to do.
Ready to go. Oh,
Learning how to juggle knives.
No, it was a joke. I was just kidding. Mama. I think they're going to come up and become Aggie. There it is. Learning to juggle knife. It's gonna be a real long show if you guys all have one at a time. No, no, it's nothing really. I can tell by the applause.
Zooming towards his prey at over 100 and
a thousand pounds of rock and not lose his lunch. Glad you're awake. This bird is a Harris hawk. How many of you know of Harris hawks and red tail hawks and goshawk? How many of you recognize those names? Not too many. But how many of you would recognize this bird by another name, commonly called the chicken hawk? Unfortunately, I hate to tell you, but there's no such species chicken hawk. Now, there are hawks such as the red tail and the Harris hawk that get into trouble. Granted, they do occasionally cause problems. But this bird's primary diet are rats and mice. And when we call him a chicken hawk, what do you suppose we think he eats? Chicken. Real hard question, wasn't it? Yes. Gibbies? If he eats chickens, therefore we feel that he is worthless, because he takes food from our mouth and money from our pocket. When in fact this bird, eating rats and mice, can eat over 2,500 mice a year. You see, when we call them chickens, it would be like this. One of you here caused trouble with me, and I dismissed you all because you're human beings. When we call them chicken hawks, we are basically cutting their throats because we are calling them worthless. When this bird's primary diet being rats and mice, it doesn't make much sense to me that we should condemn him when he is trying to eat the rats and mice, which are eating the grain, which we're trying to feed to the chicken. All of these birds have different names. They all have different purposes. For this moment, I want to explain the Harris hawk. Hopefully you can enjoy this music. Here in a moment, I'm going to bring another bird out for you. And when you see this bird, understand that much work has been done to put this bird back into the wild. Understand that many times working with the king is not an easy task. In fact, many times we receive these birds and they have been slammed to the earth. They're so very, very hard to work on them and then put them back into an environment that doesn't understand. Master Matthew, I welcome you.
Hello, John. Tell me, what are these people doing about?
These are all friends of the king and they are here to be educated.
Last week,
you got
a key, he and I just returned from the field,
simply
out of ground.
Key, and what is this bird that is on your hand?
Why, this is a red-tailed hawk.
Have you? He doesn't have a red flag.
Well, I'm glad you noticed that, John. This particular bird is less than a year of age. This explains why he doesn't have a red tail. Well, you see, these birds do not put on their adult plumage, that is, the plumage that you might recognize the bird with, until at least 20 of age. So it won't be until approximately April of next year. Then he will receive his red tail. But besides that point, this bird came to us injured. He came to us with a fractured skull, and he lost eyesight. Now he laid about for about 4 weeks. He couldn't fly, he couldn't see to fly. We took care of him as best we could. It proved very good. Here he is. Now what we are going to intend to do here in a moment is fly him. Now understand this. This is not going to be a very long flight. We're not going to show you a flamboyant flight. Instead, we're going to show you wild creatures trying very hard to secure his independence. And that is through flight. And that is what we're going to try to do here in the next moment, is secure a small flight and build upon that. We work every day with these birds, and this flight means a great deal, not only to him, but to us, because he's mates.
Every time this bird moves his head back and forth, he is using the eye that previously was not working. Every time that he has to move back and forth, he has to figure out exactly how to land on us. Now imagine last time, Matthew flew the bird to us, it slid off of the glove and landed on his shoulder. This bird has still got to learn how to land properly, or it cannot survive in the wild.
Oh,
Now you see why not everyone would want to do this. Not everyone has the patience. Not everyone can spend several hours a day with one bird at a time. It requires a great deal of time. That's why it's illegal to have these birds unless you have the proper permit. Because it does require such a great amount of time, not only time, but patience. Because you see, these are not pets. They're wild animals, and we work at their place.
Thank you. the morning, he's a damn rooster. You see how silly it is to call a hawk a chicken hawk, and how silly it is to call a chicken a chicken hawk. They all have different names. They all do different things. Why should we lump them all into one thing that is sometimes called that? I get questions all the time. Can chickens fly? Of course they can fly. Here's what we're gonna do. You stay here until I get over there. And I'll call you and we'll show everybody how you fly. You got it? Okay. You stay here. All right. You're cheating!
Ourselves. Ivy Cliff.
Ivy Gary.
together we are Full Moon Circus. Act like you've heard of us. Thank you. Now, we're about to jump from the rope to the stage. When we do, let that be thy cue. Scream, yell, clap, make it act impressed. Ready? One, two, three.
I know we're gonna get that time, Jane.